Hey guys, Mr. Spiffy here. I'm not feeling exactly the most professional tonight. I've been really kind of tired all day, and so I'm gonna make this kind of quick. This is my thoughts on the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view as an overall, and also this gives me an excuse to try out my new vlog camera. We bought a new nice new Canon still camera. It's actually two of them, one for the Spiffy Kitty and one for me. So
yay, mine's purple.
I start doing vlogs for real reels. The hope is, you know, that I can actually get some views on Spiffy's World, which we've been sorely neglecting since we opened it up about 4 or 5 months ago.
You will be seeing more videos on Spiffy's World, including Spiffy Kitty videos, as we count down to our trip to Disneyland.
Yes. So, quick thoughts on the Elimination Chamber. 5 matches total on the card. We opened up rather surprisingly with the WWE Championship Elimination Chamber. Overall, most of the match went as I expected, except for Jericho's elimination. And this was the this was my night of not getting anything right for predictions. Jericho, was knocked out of the ring and was knocked unconscious. Whether or not that was a work or was a actual injury, that is to remain to be seen at this point.
Either way, he took a bad bump and hit a camera guy.
Yeah. So we'll keep an eye on it. Keep an eye on NoDQ.com or wherever you get your news for wrestling from to find out, you know, the status of Chris Jericho. CM Punk successfully defends the World Heavyweight Championship. Rather average Elimination Chamber match. Kofi certainly being the workhorse of the match. No big surprise there, doing the one real high spot off of the top of the pod with the crossbody.
Pardon me.
And all in all, pretty good. I'd have to rate this match probably a B. You know, I've seen better, I've seen worse Elimination Chambers. And, you know, I'm coming off of the fact that I was live at the chamber last year. So, it's a bit of a different atmosphere being back at home watching it again.
And then I left to get food.
And when she left to get food, unfortunately she missed out on probably the best match of the night, in my opinion. And that was the WWE Divas title match. And I know that is going to be a shock to everybody, but the fact
I'll have to watch it later.
This match was exactly what it should have been. This is what I have been begging the WWE to do with the women's wrestling for the longest time. This is what they should have done in the first place. It was a solid match between two good workers. You had the heel running the matchup, really going out there with Beth Phoenix just owning on Tamina, and then Tamina getting the turnaround, coming very close to getting that big babyface win, only for Beth to pick up the victory with the Glam Slam 1-2-3. There's definitely room for a rematch between them at WrestleMania, or potentially a triple threat match between her, Kong, and Tamina.
That'd be good. And then we're going to be putting up a new vlog video, and you'll see what I was doing while I was missing that match.
So yeah, you can tune in to Spiffy's World for that. I'm trying to make this quick here, so.
Sorry.
Let's make this quick. All right. That match, I'm giving an A. And I'm amazed I'm giving any women's match an A, but that one was exactly what I hoped it would be. It was actually even in many ways more than I expected it to be. You then had Laurinaitis come into the ring and make his plea that he not only should become the permanent general manager of Raw, but also become the general manager of SmackDown, supplanting Teddy Long. And then you had wrestlers coming out and smooching his butt, starting with the injured Alberto Del Rio, and the injured Mark Henry, and then the injured Christian. I think we're seeing a pattern here. Three heels. Until Christian came out, I thought we were dealing with a meeting of the lesser well-known shitty promo doers club. And seriously, Alberto, can you come up with a better insult in Spanish than just calling someone a dog? It's getting old.
There are much worse things.
This segment was boring, and it wasted time.
Glad I missed it.
Continuing with the waste of time, we had another promo about John Cena, and this one was about John Cena and how he gives back to the young WWE wrestlers and letting them use his own personal and private gym. The coolest part about this was getting to see a former Ring of Honor champion, Tyler Black, now known as Seth Rollins, getting his first few minutes of real WWE airtime besides being on FCW. So that was all right. We then go into the World Heavyweight Championship Elimination Chamber. This matchup, I probably should have gone with my original thoughts on it, which was that Santino would be the last eliminated. I was wrong. Spiffy Kitty was...
I was right. I was right. Na, 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 na.
Like she said. This matchup was surprisingly good.
Came that close.
Santino really, you know, there were points where it seemed a little bit hackneyed because every time it's like, oh, we're going to throw Santino over here and then we're going to completely ignore him and go do someone else. It was the structure of the match became really obvious really quickly that was the direction that they were going with it. Not to say that was bad. The ending was solid, and while we all knew that Santino probably wasn't going to win, it at least made a believer probably out of the average fan. The average fan might have actually believed that he had that opportunity and that chance.
Those like me who cheer the underdogs like Santino and Hornswoggle, this was really great. I actually stopped eating for a second going, come on, you can do it, you can do it. And he almost broke the hold and then he tapped out. Yeah.
But
and he eliminated Cody Rhodes.
And Wade Barrett.
Yay!
So, no first British-born world champion. Oh, well.
By the way, what's with Wade Barrett's hair?
I don't know. He's apparently attached a few tribbles to the top of his head. Of course, we had what we all predicted, which is now Sheamus has basically come out and challenged Daniel Bryan, attacking
Siren
him.
Siren challenge.
You know, we just saw this match on SmackDown and ended in a DQ. I guess we've got the build towards WrestleMania on it. It's just, we just got it for free on TV. The only key point behind it is that unless this match goes in as a no DQ or a no count, you know, something where Bryan has to stay in, defend, and there's no way out of it, it's not going to work. It's not going to have that same pay-per-view buy draw.
We missed the whole thing where Big Show breaking into the capsule to get...
Oh, yes. And that was a first, you know...
That was awesome. That was definitely a first.
And just breaking down into Daniel Bryan's capsule. I mean, I've seen times where... There was a previous one where I think it was RVD who had climbed
They've
up
done
on top
stuff
of
like that, but...
the pod, and Chris Jericho or someone had yanked his foot through the pod and like
right.
You know, but never before breaking
the chains
and getting into the pod to go after someone who had not yet been released. The closest to that we ever had was when Jericho or someone was thrown through one of the pods that someone was still in.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was about as close as you got on that one.
Okay.
So.
And then they did a really, really stupid Natalya bit that I finally get to see what they've been doing with her. I feel sorry for both her and Hornswoggle having to be part of that sketch. That entire sketch, the later bit with Vicky and all that too. Okay. The Natalya thing, we've already said, it's dumb. Stop it. Natalya is a multi-generation superstar now. They really...
This is all they could do
it's
to get her over?
Terrible. It's just terrible.
It is.
And then, okay. Yes, Vicky is older. Yes, she is a heel manager. But she's actually starting to look really good. They called her ugly and cottage cheese legs. But she looked good in that dress. Okay? The older women can still look good. And she has lost weight. I don't promote weight loss. But she was actually looking pretty good. She wasn't wearing something frumpy.
Anyway.
That whole sketch was just... Ugh.
By the way, final score for... That mat for the second elimination chamber, B+. We then had the filler match of the evening: Jack Swagger defending the U.S. title against Justin Gabriel. This match was basic. It could have belonged on SmackDown or Superstars or Raw. It was a C-. It wasn't. It did what it was supposed to do. It filled time. We had a promo for The Rock's upcoming DVD. Yay, woo, Rock. I'm not buying it. Probably not, unless I find it at Rasputin.
They're just having every excuse to make another DVD. They're trying to shove these things down our throats.
Yeah, no, unless it gets sold back to Rasputin, I can buy it for like $5 or something, and then I'll probably buy it. Last match on the card at no longer WWE Elimination Chamber, but WWE Ambulance Match. We have John Cena versus Kane. The only match I got right on the card. I said Cena wins. That's all. No heel turn. No nothing else. He's not, you know, not going to embrace
wait,
about
wait.
That.
Go.
Sorry about that. My camera cut out. I guess we've learned the time frame length on the on this camera for shooting video. All right. So as I was saying, see nothing happened. No Rock appearance. No Cena turning heel. No truly embracing the hate. Nothing. It's all bullshit. Cena wins. He's still John Cena.
He's still the hero.
Whoopity-doo, yay, yay, woo. All he does is he has a little bit more confidence about himself going in to face The Rock in 6 weeks at WrestleMania. And there was much rejoicing. Yay, yay.
Yeah.
I spent more time paying attention to the boards than I was on this match, honestly. It was...
Yep.
Shane McMahon versus Kane in an ambulance match was significantly better than this. This matchup was a C. For all of the build-up that it had, this match was average. There was no spectacular spots. The biggest one, of course, was the FU off of the... off of the top of the ambulance into the clearly blocked off stunt pad area for Kane to go into. And obviously they didn't shine the camera down in there so that no one could see that there was a big inflatable mattress that Kane happily bounced onto.
Mattress!
So, that match was... ending of the pay-per-view was kind of flat. If they had ended it, I think, with the Elimination Chamber match, that would have been a much better
that
ending.
That would have been a higher
point. With Sheamus standing tall over top the World Heavyweight Champion, that would have been a solid way to end the pay-per-view. Instead, we end with meh, and meh is all we're going to get leading into probably the quote-unquote biggest match in WrestleMania history. I'm sorry, The Rock versus Hulk Hogan was bigger. I don't care at this point. It's still going to sell. It's still going to get high buy rates. It's still going to get millions of buys coming back to WWE, which is great for the business. But someone like me is probably not going to be as hyped about it as I probably will for some of the other matches on the card. Hopefully Chris Jericho is not truly injured. I really do want to see CM Punk one-on-one with Jericho. And final score overall for this pay-per-view was a B-. Could have been better, could have been worse. The things that made it great were great, and the things that made it really shitty were truly shitty. I'm Mr. Spiffy, and I need a shower.
And now for Kitty Kunis. Aw, she was chasing it. She was playing with a Wendy spoon. Now she's not doing anything. Oh, well. Good night.